gravity has been brought to popular attention in recent years through the extremes of travel into space. For instance, the forces involved in the acceleration and deceleration of satellites, simulated in this centrifugal trainer, are measured in G's, or multiples of the mass attraction exerted by the Earth. Now, the effects of gravity, or weight, are several. As an unbalanced force, it will produce acceleration. As a balanced force, it will only produce stress in the object upon which it acts. Except for such stress, the object might then just as well be weightless, like bodies in space. Quite similar to the zero gravity of outer space is the neutral buoyancy experienced when swimming underwater. If we combine the expression for the force per unit volume due to pressure gradient with that for the force per unit volume due to gravity, which involves the specific weight or fluid weight per unit volume, gamma, a simple expression for any component of the two together will result. This can then be equated to the product of the density and the corresponding component of acceleration. If it is noted that the ratio of gamma to rho is the gravitational acceleration g, division of all terms of the foregoing equation by gamma will show that the sum of pressure head and elevation must change at a rate proportional to the relative acceleration in that direction. In a direction in which there is no acceleration, the sum must be constant. This condition is known as hydrostatic pressure distribution. In a cylindrical tank of water that is rotating with a constant angular speed, for example, the pressure distribution is non-hydrostatic radially because of the centripetal acceleration, but hydrostatic vertically because there is no vertical acceleration. Now, if the sum of pressure head and elevation is replaced by the piezometric head H, then the dimensionless pressure-velocity relationship for non-gravitational flow will be found to have as its gravitational counterpart an almost identical expression. That is, the pressure distribution curves for flow without gravitational action are identical to those for the variation of H with flow through the same boundaries in a gravitational field. Since H represents the height to which liquid will rise in a glass manometer connected to a piezometric opening, the constancy of the liquid levels in the manometers shows the lack of dependence of the piezometric head upon the orientation of this flow passage. In confined flow, therefore, fluid weight has no effect upon the flow pattern. Its sole influence is to increase the pressure head, P over gamma, in proportion to the decrease in elevation. The dimensional form of the pressure-velocity relationship has its gravitational counterpart in what is known as the Bernoulli equation, which states that the sum of velocity head, pressure head, and elevation must yield the same total head, capital H, at all points in steady irrotational flow. Since the total head is the height to which liquid would rise in a manometer connected to a stagnation tube, the Bernoulli terms are especially suitable to graphical representation, for the velocity head is the distance between the horizontal line of total head and the line of piezometric head below. A gradual change in rate of flow causes the two sets of manometer columns to rise or fall proportionate distances. Gravity exerts an accelerative effect upon fluid motion only when the flow in question has a locally inclined free surface. This is best illustrated by a liquid flowing in contact with the atmosphere, as in this vertical jet. Since the free surface is a line of zero pressure, the stagnation point coincides with the maximum level attainable, the line of total head, and the velocity head increases on either side of the stagnation point as the surface decreases in elevation. The velocity at points within the flow is related to that of free surface points by the flow net. The pressure at any internal point then follows from the Bernoulli equation. It is evident that an internal pressure must exist, for only the lateral pressure gradient is available to produce the required horizontal acceleration of each half of the flow. A jet shown in the second film to illustrate the free streamline principle was photographed in such a way as to eliminate the effect of gravity. If a similar jet is now observed in a gravitational field, the relative influence of the fluid weight will become the greater as the velocity head, relative to the orifice dimension, decreases. The square root of twice this ratio is the Froude number introduced in the first film.